Hello and welcome to Brush My Con channel. Today we'll talk about complex numbers. We'll start with what is a complex number. We'll see a couple of properties of complex numbers. Then we'll look into a couple of problem types. The first one is simplifying expressions with complex numbers. Example, 2 plus 3i multiplied by 3i square plus 4i cube. How can we simplify this? The second one is real and imaginary part problems, where we'll compare a complex number like 2 plus 3i with a plus ib. The third one is multiplying with conjugate problems, where we'll try to simplify a complex number like this. And the fourth one will be simplifying large power complex numbers. Example is I raised to a very large number. Let's start with the definition of complex numbers. So complex numbers are numbers which can be expressed as a plus iota b, where a and b are real numbers and I is called as an imaginary number, where I is nothing but square root of minus 1, or I can also be expressed as the solution of the equation x square is equal to minus 1. Let's take some examples. 2 plus 3i, where 2 becomes your real part and 3 becomes your imaginary part of the complex number. Now this I is the imaginary number and is also called as iota. Now let's go through some of the properties of complex numbers. Now we already know I is square root of minus 1. Let's see what happens if I square both the sides. So I square will be square of square root of minus 1, which is nothing but minus 1 itself. Let's try to find I cube. So I cube can be written as I raised to 1 plus 2, which is nothing but I raised to 1 multiplied by I raised to 2. Now I raised to 1 can be written as I, and I square we already know is minus 1. So this becomes minus I. Let's try I raised to 4. So I raised to 4, I can write it as I square whole square, which is nothing but minus 1 whole square, which becomes plus 1. Let's try I raised to 5 now. So I raised to 5 can be written as I raised to 1 plus 4, or nothing but I multiplied by I raised to 4. Now we know that I raised to 4 is 1. So that means I raised to 5 becomes I multiplied by 1, which is nothing but I. Let's try I raised to 6. I raised to 6 can be written as I raised to 2 plus 4, which is nothing but I square multiplied by I raised to 4, and we know I square is minus 1 and I raised to 4 is 1. That means I raised to 6 becomes minus 1. And if you notice, I raised to 6 is actually equal to I square. So the powers of I actually follow a pattern where I raised to 1 will be equal to I raised to 5, is equal to I raised to 9, and so on. I square will be equal to I raised to 6, will be equal to I raised to 10, and so on. So you will see the powers differ by 4, and after every fourth number, the powers keep on repeating. So it actually has a cycle of 4. Now let's go ahead and solve some of the problem types based on the theory which you have learned just now. And let's try to apply the theory in those problems. So the first one is simplifying expressions with complex numbers. Now when you're trying to add two complex numbers, you can add the real parts together, and you can add the complex parts together. So here I can go ahead and add the real parts to have 2 plus 3. And then I can add the complex parts together to have 3 plus 4i, which will make this as 5 plus 7i. So remember, in case of complex numbers, you can always add the real parts together and the complex parts together. Let's try the second one. Here we have to multiply two complex numbers. When you're multiplying two complex numbers, consider I as like a variable, and you can multiply as you do your normal multiplication. So here I can multiply 2 with 3, then 2 with 4i, plus 3i with 3, and 3i with 4i. Now let's try to simplify this. So we'll have 6 plus 8i plus 9i plus 12i square. So this becomes 6 plus 17i And we know that I square is equal to minus 1. So let's replace that and we'll have minus 12. So this becomes your 17i minus 6. So remember, whenever you are trying to multiply two complex numbers, you can consider I like a variable and do multiplication as you'll do in a normal case. Let's try some more problems. So here I have to multiply 2 plus 3i with 3i square plus 4i cube. Let's try to simplify this first. So we'll have 2 plus 3i multiplied by, we know I square is minus 1 and I cube is nothing but minus I. So this becomes 3 minus 4i. Now let's go ahead and multiply this as we have done in the previous problem. So we'll have 2 into minus 3 minus 2 into 4i minus 3 into 3i minus 3i into 4i. So this becomes minus 6 minus 8i minus 9i, and this becomes minus 12i square, but we know I square is minus 1. So that means minus 12 multiplied by minus 1, which makes it as plus 12. So this is nothing but 6 minus 17i. Let's try the fourth one. So 3 plus 4i square multiplied by 5i cube minus 2i raised to 4. We know I square is minus 1. So this becomes 3 minus 4. I cube is minus I. So multiplied by minus 5i, and I raised to 4 is 1. So minus 2, which is nothing but minus 1 multiplied by minus 5i minus 2, which is nothing but 5i plus 2. Let's try problem type 2 now. So here the problems are about finding real and imaginary parts. So in the first one, 2 plus 3i is equal to a plus ib, and we need to find the value of a plus b. So when you're comparing two complex numbers, you can always equate their real part and their imaginary part. So here I can compare the real parts to have 2 is equal to a, and the imaginary parts to have 3 is equal to b. That means the value of a plus b will be nothing but 2 plus 3, which is nothing but 5. Let's try the second one. So 3 plus 2i multiplied by 7i square minus 3i cube is equal to a minus ib, and we have to find the value of a plus b. Let's simplify this first. So we'll have 3 plus 2i multiplied by, we know I square is minus 1, so minus 7, and I cube is minus I. That means this becomes plus 3i. Now this is equal to a minus ib. So let's multiply the left hand side first. So we'll have 3 into minus 7 plus 3 into 3i minus 2i into 7 plus 2i into 3i, which is nothing but minus 21 plus 9i minus 14i plus 6i square. And we know I square is minus 1. So this becomes minus 21 minus 5i minus 6, which is nothing but minus 27 minus 5i. Now we know minus 27 minus 5i is equal to a minus ib. And we know that we can compare the real parts to have a is equal to minus 27 and the imaginary parts. So b is equal to plus 5. That means a plus b becomes minus 27 plus 5, which is minus 22. Let's try some more problems. So 5 plus 3i plus 11i square minus 4i cube is equal to a minus ib, and we need to find the value of a and b. So let's simplify this first. So we'll have 5 plus 3i plus, we know I square is equal to minus 1. That means this becomes minus 11, and I cube is minus I. So plus 4i is equal to a minus ib. Now I can add the real parts. So 5 and minus 11 will give me minus 6, and 3i plus 4i will be 7i, and that equals my a minus ib. Now I can compare the real and imaginary parts. So that will give me a is equal to minus 6 and b is equal to minus 7. Let's try the fourth one. So 7 plus 2i minus 5i cube minus 4i square is equal to a minus ib. and we need to find the value of minimum of A and B. So whatever is the minimum out of A and B, we need to find the value of that. So let's simplify this first. So we'll have 7 plus 2i minus I cube is nothing but minus I, so that becomes minus 5i, and I square is minus 1, so that becomes plus 4 is equal to A minus IB. Now we can add the real parts, but before doing that, let's remove the sign. So we'll have 7 plus 2i plus 5i minus 4, which is nothing but 3 plus 7i, and it is equal to A minus IB. That means A is equal to 3 and B is equal to minus 7. And the question is asking us to find the minimum of A and B. And here we know that B is the minimum value. So that means minimum of A and B is minus 7. Let's try the next problem type. Now this problem type is on multiplying with conjugate of the complex number. Now let's see what is conjugate of a complex number. The first one is we have to simplify 2 plus 3i divided by 3 plus 4i. Now here we have complex number both in numerator and denominator. The idea of multiplying with conjugate is we want to get rid of the complex number in the denominator. And the way we do that is we'll multiply with 3 minus 4i. So almost the same expression as what we have in the denominator, but we are going to change the sign of the imaginary part. So here we have a positive sign. We are going to replace it with a negative sign when we are multiplying the numerator and denominator with that. So let's go ahead and do that. So in the numerator, we'll have 2 plus 3i multiplied with 3 minus 4i. And in denominator, 3 plus 4i multiplied by 3 minus 4i. Now, if you notice, in the denominator, we'll have something like a plus b multiplied by a minus b, and we know that this is nothing but a square minus b square. So let's go ahead and do that. And in numerator, we are going to multiply as we have done in the previous problems. So numerator becomes 2 multiplied by 3 minus 2 multiplied by 4i plus 3 multiplied by 3i minus 3i multiplied by 4i, and denominator becomes a square minus b square. So 3 square minus 4i square. Let's simplify the numerator. This becomes 6. This is minus 8i plus 9i becomes plus I. So 6 plus I. And this becomes minus 12i square. And we know I square is minus 1. So that means it becomes plus 12 divided by denominator becomes 9. And this becomes 16i square. And we know I square is minus 1, so that means it becomes plus 16. So the simplified version of 2 plus 3i divided by 3 plus 4i will be 18 plus I divided by 25. So here we got rid of the complex part in the denominator, and now we have complex part only in the numerator. Let's try the same thing for the next one. So if 3 plus 4i divided by 4 minus 5i is equal to a plus ib, then find the value of a plus b. So let's go and eliminate the complex part in the denominator by multiplying with the conjugate. So 3 plus 4i divided by 4 minus 5i. Now remember, when you're selecting the conjugate, you just have to change the sign of the complex part. So I'll multiply this with 4 plus 5i divided by 4 plus 5i. Let's go ahead and multiply the numerator. So this becomes 3 multiplied by 4, so 12, plus 3 multiplied by 5i, 15i, 4i multiplied by 4, plus 16i, and 4i multiplied by 5i, so 20i square. And denominator is a minus b times a plus b, so it becomes a square minus b square. Now we know I square is minus 1, and 15i plus 16i becomes 31i. So 12 plus 31i, and this becomes minus 20 divided by, this becomes minus 25 I square, and we know I square is minus 1. So 16 plus 25 will become 41. So the simplified version is minus 8 plus 31i divided by 41 or nothing but minus 8 by 41 plus 31i by 41. Let's try the fourth problem type now. So this is on simplifying large power complex numbers. Let's try the first one. So I raised to 230 plus I raised to 221 plus I raised to 343 plus I raised to 120 is equal to A plus IB. And they're asking if A is greater than B. Now this is a very large power of I and we need to simplify this first. Now remember that powers of I repeat after every fourth power. So I raised to 1 is same as I raised to 5 is same as I raised to 9 and so on. So let's take a power of I, let's say 141. If we divide that by 4 and get a remainder, then I raised to this power, which is 141 in this case, will be the same as I raised to 1. So let's apply this concept in this problem. So I raised to 230, so we'll divide 230 by 4 and get the remainder as 2. That means I raised to 230 is same as I raised to 2. 221 when divided by 4 gives us 1 remainder. That means I raised to 221 is same as I raised to 1. 343 gives us 3 remainder, so this becomes I raised to 3. And 120 gives us 0 remainder. That means I raised to 120 is same as I raised to 0 or is same as I raised to 4, which is nothing but 1. So this becomes equal to A plus IB. Now let's simplify this. I square is minus 1 plus I. I cube is minus I. And this is 1. So this becomes plus I and minus I will cancel out. And plus 1 and minus 1 will cancel out. So this will become 0 is equal to A plus IB. That means both A and B are 0. And the question is A greater than B? So the answer is no, because both of them are equal. Let's try the next one. So I raised to 123 plus I raised to 420 minus I raised to 340 plus I raised to 120 is equal to A minus IB. And the question is A less than B? So let's divide these numbers by 4 and get the remainder. So this becomes I raised to 3 plus 420 is divisible by 4. So this becomes I raised to 0, which is nothing but 1. 340 is divisible by 4. So again, this becomes 1. 120 is also divisible by 4. So this also becomes 1. We know that I cube is minus I. So this becomes minus I plus 1 is equal to A minus IB or nothing but A is equal to 1 and B is also equal to 1. That means A is equal to B. The question is A less than B? The answer is no, because both of them are equal. I hope you were able to get your concepts clear for complex numbers and see the different types of problems which typically come in complex numbers. If you did, please go ahead and like the video, provide your valuable comments, and do share this video with your friends and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.